Excellent counter. What ring presence.
Well, from the looks of things, it's not hard to tell how this one's gonna go.
What are you talking about, King? I think this is still an extremely competitive match that could go either way.
You know, JR, it's obvious that the only exercise you get is stretching the truth or jumping to conclusions.
Well, judging from the shape I'm in, I don't appear to be doing too much of either, King. You're looking pretty fit, though, I must say.
He reversed it!
I'm sure I'm not the only one in this arena who hopes to see the masterpiece learn a lesson in respect here tonight.
Hey, watch your mouth. This man is a living work of art.
Well, then maybe someone should hang him on a wall in the museum.
Randy Orton is a genius, JR. As soon as he got what he needed from Triple H and Ric Flair, he turned on him and struck out on his own.
I think you've got a selective memory there, Fish. I seem to remember Triple H and Ric Flair turning on Orton and knocking some of the cockiness out of him when they did it.
Well, if that's true, it's just a chance. And I think that's pretty sad, coming from two men who have more than 25 world title reigns between them.
The Game and Flair are no strangers to championship gold. But Orton won it younger than either one of them. And don't think he didn't let it go straight to his head either.
You always see the worst in people, JR. Why shouldn't Orton be proud of being the youngest world champion in WWE history? I don't think these superstars have any intention of taking it easy on each other tonight.
That's not what they signed up for, King. And quite frankly, I think these fans would be disappointed if they didn't go all out.
Well, that's easy for the fans to say. They've never set foot inside that ring.
No, but they spend their hard-earned dollars to watch what goes on inside it. And without them, we'd all be out of a job.
Stand here tonight. I think flat on your back with your shoulders on the mat is no place to be.
He's leaving the ringside area in a foul mood.
Have you ever seen him in anything but a foul mood?
Well, occasionally he's a little smug, but he's got good reason to be upset. He just lost his championship opportunity.
And I'm sure the champ is glad he's not the number one contender.
I don't know about that. After that performance, I think the champ would be happy to have a rematch.
It could have gone either way, and I don't think the champ would have gotten that lucky twice.
I've got a special announcement for WWE fans worldwide. Now, you know I'm not one to toot my own horn, but thanks to the effusive praise of ECW's representative, I've decided to give myself and WWE fans an early Christmas present this year and induct myself into the WWE Hall of Fame.
Damn, I never thought I'd see ECW join Vince McMahon's special club on live TV.
Say the word, Mr. McMahon, and this chump is no more.
Man, I think you put your head way too far up a certain butt. Go ahead and send your boys. I need to warm up.
Yeah. I still see. you really stole my dad's thunder. I'm impressed. But watch out. You've gotten on the wrong side of two of the most powerful figures in sports entertainment, and they're not going to let that slide.
And now I live with control. With no reason to lie.
What's going on between you and Mr. McMahon? You disrespected ECW, and you're gonna pay for that. This week, I'm coming to your house, and I'm gonna teach you the meaning of extreme.
Less than 3 weeks remain until New Year's Revolution. Jim Ross and Jerry Lawler at ringside. And did you see how the champion disrespected Mr. McMahon and ECW?
I got no problem with him talking trash to ECW, but insulting the chairman, that's career suicide.
And ECW has vowed retribution on the champion here tonight.
If I were the champ, I'd be more worried about what Mr. McMahon's got in store for me.
Here comes young CM Punk, a superstar who's been making quite a name for himself in ECW.
Yeah, and that name is Punk, which is exactly what he is. I hope the champ wipes the canvas with this kid.
Sounding
like some sort of wacko conspiracy theorist, but I smell a setup, JR.
God, a thunderous blow from that sledgehammer.
Man, talk about getting hammered.
And what a slumber knocker of a shot with that sledgehammer.
That'll rearrange your facial features for sure, JR. You gotta respect the commitment and the dedication. He's bringing the hammer down, JR!
He sure is, and the longer he holds that sledgehammer, the uglier it's gonna get.
After some of the things we've seen in this ring, JR, I think we'd better remind them.
What a vicious chair shot!
That chair was never meant to be used like that, JR. You talk about ruthless aggression. Look at the way these superstars have been going after each other.
They're not playing with kid gloves, that's for sure.
We knew we were going to see a heck of a match, but here's the cover, JR.
One, two, three.
I don't think he feels like he got the respect he thinks he deserves.
What? Was he expecting that the Raw fans were going to show him any respect?
That's pretty unlikely, considering he's an ECW superstar.
Not to mention a snot-nosed little punk.
And I don't have a peaceful, easy feeling that this is the last we've seen of ECW.
Probably not, especially if Mr. McMahon gets his way, and he usually does.
All my sunshine and smile.